Hey guys, it's Jesse from FPS Squared, and Call of Duty Black Ops 3 has a new DLC out, if you're on PlayStation 4, that is, and it's called Awakening. It's only on PlayStation 4 as of right now. It's coming out on Xbox and PC, and I don't know about last-gen consoles. I don't know if they're getting the DLCs or not, but it's coming out on Xbox One and PC in a month, like next month. So it's $15, $14.99. You get four new multiplayer maps. You get a few new melee weapons. At least I'm about 90% sure that they are new melee weapons. I've never noticed them before. And you also get, of course, the new zombies map. Dare something. I can't remember the name of it. But first thing we're going to do is we're going to check out the new melee weapons. So you can see here you've got this thing, which I'm not sure what that is. Again, I'm about 90% sure these haven't been in the game before, but I don't know. I could be wrong. There's about a 10% chance that I'm wrong. You have this thing, which is obviously a wrench, and you have this thing, which is obviously some sort of brass knuckles. You have to unlock these with the loot things. I forget what they're called. What are they called? The black market things. You have to get them from a supply drop, either a common or a rare. There is no way to unlock them, I don't think, just without having to open them from a supply drop. So you get that, and then of course you also get four new multiplayer maps. Let's just go to a custom game real quick and do a real quick overview of them all. I have played on them all at least once, so I kind of know a little bit about them, but they're still pretty new to me. So you get Gauntlet, which is this. If you look at the thumbnail, you can see there's three different areas. There's like a snowy area, a jungle area, and then like a town area. Basically, it's like a training facility that they use. I don't know. That's like the setup for it, is it's a training facility with three different environments. You have Skyjacked, which is a remake of the popular map Hijacked from Black Ops 2. One of my favorite maps in Black Ops 2, and really in Call of Duty in general. I really enjoyed that map. The spin on it here in Black Ops 3 is that it's in the air, and you're on an airship instead of just regular ship in the ocean. Pretty much same exact map. There's a few modifications for like the wall run and the jetpack and stuff that's in this game, but for the most part, it's the exact same map as Hijacked. You have Splash, which is this pretty cool. I think it's my favorite map from the DLC. Well, maybe second favorite. I like Skyjacked a lot. But my second favorite map from the DLC. It's like this old abandoned water park. And it's pretty cool. Maybe not necessarily in terms of the way it plays and the way battles go and stuff like that and how it concentrates action. But it's got a really nice art style, and I like the colors and stuff. Treyarch always goes crazy with their DLC maps. They always do something just fucking batshit crazy, and this is the map where they just went haywire with. It's really cool. I like it. And then you have Rise, which is just like a standard map to me. It feels kind of like one of like the stock maps from Black Ops 1, like a mix of WMD and Array, kind of, and a little bit of Silo. I don't know. It's pretty cool. It's like a abandoned construction site or something. And then Nuketown's not part of this DLC. So that's the four maps you get with the map pack. And we're going to take a look at all of these individually in a second. And then, of course, you also get the new zombies map, if I can get into it. And it's called Dare Eichendrosh. I don't know if I'm saying that correct, but it's pretty cool. We'll take a look at that at the end of the video. I know a lot of people like zombies, so if you want to just go straight to the zombies, you can click the annotation on your screen right now, and you can see zombies. But just know, this is really an overview. I'm not really going to go in-depth and try to find all the map secrets and, you know, all the little things that, you know, zombies is known for. So, if you want that, this is not the video for you. I'm just going to show you an overview of the map, maybe the first few areas and do a few rounds. Okay, so that's everything in the DLC. That I've noticed. I'm not sure if anything else. I don't think I'm missing anything, but what I'm going to do now is we're going to go and we're going to take a look at the four multiplayer maps in a bot match. So let's get right into it. All right, guys, we're getting into a private bot match here so I can show you guys around Rise. We're just going to go down the list in order. We're going to start with Rise. I like this map. I think you guys will like it too. There's a few complaints I have, but I'll get into that when we actually get into the match. Again, this is like a snowy, kind of really just classically played map. There's not a whole lot of places to like do your wall run or anything. I mean, there are, but it doesn't really work very well. It's a very standard Call of Duty flowing map. And I think you'll see what I mean when we get in to the game. Team Deathmatch. Kind of brings you back. Like I say, oh, I'm not in a bot match. But that's okay, because we just want to explore the map anyway. We might do a real multiplayer match in a minute. But the problem with that is they don't have a playlist for some reason. Up. At least they didn't yesterday when the DLC came out. There wasn't a playlist up for just DLC maps. They might have it up now, but we'll check that out in a second. So yeah, this is the map. You can see it's pretty standard looking. Like, it's nothing too crazy. They do have a few places you can jump up in and, you know, try to pick people off. But for the most part, it's a very like grounded map compared to the other ones. You know, a few places you can wall run, but I don't know. It just feels like a very old school Call of Duty map to me. I enjoy it. That's not to say that it's not enjoyable. It's just, it doesn't fit very well with Black Ops 3, in my opinion. But, you know, oh, I mean, it's a Call of Duty map. You know, you shoot shit, you die, you respawn, you shoot more shit. I would say this is probably, in terms of size, this is probably, you know, one of the more medium-sized maps. This is probably the more medium-sized map of the DLC. Gauntlet and Skyjacked, obviously, are both pretty small maps. And then Splash is kind of large. I would call this one pretty medium, though. You see, we've already looped around completely. That's pretty much the way it looks. There's like this little open area here where people can get up in these windows. You know, a little side area back here that people probably will never go to ever. But then again, there might be some campers back here. And then, you know, the enemy team spawn back here. There's a few areas. I feel like in a map called Rise, there should be more areas that, you know, have places that are high up. I mean, the map is called Rise, but these windows are pretty much the highest you can get, you know, unless you want a wall run. Oh, looky here. Oh, I thought maybe you'd be able to get up there. You know what? You might be able to. Let me try it. That'd be pretty sick, but pretty unlikely at the same time, honestly. Yeah, you can't get up there. That's a shame. I feel like there needs to be a little bit more verticality in this map, honestly. There is this little wall water thing here because it is Black Ops 3 and they want to make sure you know that you can swim now. But like I say, for the most part, this is a pretty standard map. I'm going to back out and show you guys the next one. Now, I think the next one is, actually, I don't remember what the next one is, unless it's Skyjack. Oh, I think it's Splash. This next one's probably my second favorite map of the entire DLC. I've only actually got on, in real multiplayer, I've only played on it once. I've done like a few bot matches in it, just checking it out, looking around, but real multiplayer, I've only done it once, and I really like the way where the action is concentrated and just overall the way it flows. I think it's really a nice map. And it works well in Black Ops 3, in my opinion. But let's wait until we get in to tell you about it. Loading times are annoying. Alright. So, yeah, Splash is the next one. Let's check out Splash. Again, this one's just like a really random, just crazy map. This may be the only map. I don't know. This is the only map that directly says it's in the United States in this game. That's something interesting. I'll have to look that up and see any other games that are in the United States. Not that that really matters or is important at all, but just an interesting little fact. I'm pretty sure this is probably the most biggest, but this is probably the biggest and like most complex kind of mazy map there is in the entire DLC. There's a lot of corridors and places you can get. Really cool. I like it a lot in terms of like the design, the art design of the map. I think is really cool. You see like one team spawns on like this Main Street USA type Disney World thing, and I think that looks pretty cool. You can even go in one of the buildings over here. It's where we'll start. Again, like most people probably, this isn't really where the action concentrates, of course. I'll show you where the action is in a second. You can see like there's just a lot of corridors just right off the bat. Like lots of alleys, lots of little hidden pathways, like little places that go off the beaten path and stuff. Pretty complex, big map. Now you can see there's a little bit of the facilities here of like the behind the scenes of the amusement park. Broke down river ride. You can see we're in a giant boat right now, which is pretty cool. And then this is my favorite thing. You go out of these big slides here, and right here is the center of the map. And this is where a lot of action concentrates itself. This is where you'll be dying and killing a whole bunch, is right around in here. Lots of people like to get around. I've only played Team Deathmatch, so I don't know where like flags spawn and stuff, but I would imagine a Treyarch game B will be right fucking here. But don't take my word on that, because I don't know. I just overall like how it's got a little bit of verticality to it. It's got a lot more verticality. You can get up in these things and over there. And then there's another one over here. Another slide. Over here. And I really like the lighting in these slides. It looks very... like, this is the way it looks when you're in one of those stupid plastic water slides at amusement parks. But this is definitely... this area right here is definitely where you'll be keeping... or most of the action will be happening. There's also a little bit of water over here that you can swim in. And there's like a little tunnel over here. Which is, again, they want to make sure you know you can swim in Call of Duty now, so I'm not really a big fan of the swimming mechanic, but whatever, it's there. You know, there's some more facility stuff over here. You go back, oh, this is where we've already been. On Main Street. We've already been up there too. Again, not enough verticality. This shouldn't be an exit. You should be able to get up in like a tower and fucking snipe people away. But obviously, Call of Duty isn't like that anymore, so you just have to get over it. There's this little tunnel here. Right here reminded me of... a lot of action kind of centers itself around here, too, because the center of the map's right there, and a lot of people will be coming out right there, and then enemies spawn right here. Well, I mean, that's relative, but a spawn point is back there, so... again, I like this area. This is pretty cool. Reminded me of Dead Island. Back here, you've got a little bit of, like, more water stuff. I think this actually goes into that pool we were in earlier. Yeah, it does. You can see. Again, a lot of traffic flows into that center in this map. There's, like, a little locker room back here. And then back here is where the opposite spawn of where we spawned and where the enemies spawn. That's pretty much most of this map, too. It's a pretty cool map. I like it a lot. So let's check out Skyjacked, excuse me. It's a draw. Stand down. We'll check out Skyjacked. Again, it's like a carbon copy replica. There's a few minor differences to, like, incorporate the wall run and stuff. Before we go into Skyjacked, though, I'm going to restart my PlayStation recording because I've been recording for a while. And I might be running out of time. But Skyjacked is really cool. I like it a lot. I do like it a lot. waiting on them loading times as usual. I don't know if they've added like any camos or anything like that into it. It's possible. I haven't looked at the notes for what came in the DLC. I've just tried to find it myself. So there could be like some new calling cards or something like that, or new camos, but I doubt it. Anyway, let me restart the recording, and I will see you guys at the Switch, and we'll take a look at Skyjacked. Alright, so we're back, and we're going to be taking a look at Skyjacked. Like I was saying before, I really do like this map. You know, I'm kind of on the fence about them remaking maps. I think it's pretty annoying. I don't know. I feel like maybe when you pay $15 for something, you should get all new content. But at the same time, I mean, I do like this map. So I'm a little conflicted there. I think I lean more towards they should not remake maps and charge for them. But whatever. If it was a carbon copy, like exact copy, maybe it would be a little more annoying. But it does have some differences. So, and they do want to make money. So there's that. But still, it is mildly annoying. So you can see, first off, you have to wall run if you want to get across this area. That's like one of the main differences. That's pretty much like the only difference I've noticed. There is another difference, and you see it right there, and I'll show you what it is in a minute. Other than that, it's exactly the same map, pretty much. It's just on an airship instead. You know, this is a little different. It's like a balcony now instead of a closed in, but still same exact map as Hijacked for the most part and for all intents and purposes. I'm trying to like find any major differences other than that wall run thing, and honestly I can't really think of anything except for that one thing that I was telling you about earlier, which I'm going to go show you right now. When you go downstairs, there is still a basement in this. This is the shittiest part of Hijacked and this map. It's really terrible. But the catch is now it's got like a hole in it. I don't know if you can actually get out. You can be pretty skilled, maybe. Yeah, you can. You could. Let me try to get out of there. You have to be pretty skilled with the jetpack though to get out of there. Let me try it again. See if I can get it. I imagine that you could also hop in, so it does add a little bit of map, like, play difference, like you have to watch your right side now, or your left side if you're on this side, but you have to watch this giant hole now, instead of just watching the two entry points that used to be in the map. Alright, here I go. Okay, so yeah, you totally can hop out of there if you really try, and hop in. You could hop in too if you were good, unlike me. But yeah, pretty much besides those two differences, the wall running and the big hole in the side of the downstairs, it's the same exact map. Plays pretty much the same too. I think B's here and then A and C are in the spawns. Again, I haven't played Domination, so I wouldn't know. But this is probably, I mean, it is. It's my favorite map, and it's ridiculous because it's just a remake, and it's kind of, you know, I'm not going to get into a debate on what is, you know, on lazy developing or anything like that, but you know, it's pretty annoying that it's the same map, but at the same time it's a damn good map, so I don't know. Take that as you will. That's Skyjacked. The last map we're gonna look at is Gauntlet, and it's easily the worst map in the DLC. It will be the one that everyone never votes for. Splash Might, you know, as much as I like it, I will also concede that Splash might also be one that people never vote for because it is a big map and it's kind of, you know, a little bit more slower pace than I think people would like in Call of Duty. Not to say that it isn't fast-paced, just slow for Call of Duty. Loading times, awkward silences from Jesse. That made it even more awkward, I'm sorry. Okay, so let's take a look at the final multiplayer map here, and then we'll take a look at zombies. Let's see. Change map. Shit, I've done that standard thing like 3 times in a row now. All right, Gauntlet. Yeah, like I said earlier, I don't really care for this game, this map at all. It's not really, and it doesn't really have anything, this is going to be ridiculous, but it doesn't really have anything to do with the way it plays. It's just like, I don't like the way it looks. But also from what I've seen in multiplayer maps, other people don't like it for some reasons, because it never gets voted for whenever it gets put up on the little map vote ballot thing. So, again, I think this is probably, for most people, this is the worst map in the DLC, including myself. So, again, this is like the whole setup for this is that it's a training facility. That's why there's like 3 different areas. I don't know if this has anything to do with that augmented reality of Black Ops 3's narrative. I don't know if this is like a real thing or if this is like something that's all in like your brain chip. But either way, it's not good. So you see on the right side here, this map is like a classic 3-lane Treyarch map, with one lane being this jungle here that you can go through, and there is like a cut through right here to the middle lane, but this is your, like, this jungle is one lane here, and it's okay. Again, I really don't care for this map. You go back here, this is where obviously the enemy would have spawned if we were playing a real game. There are also like these little facility areas that are in like right in front of the spawns of each map, but they're not big and nobody ever is in them. Then off, this is the middle lane. It's like this Arctic kind of icy looking place. I thought maybe you could jump down here. You can't. You can wall run though on it if you want. This is like the middle lane here. And then, of course, if you were looking at the thumbnail, right here is the third lane, which is like a little town thing. This is my favorite part of the map. Again, I judge things on very superficial reasons. Like, I just like the way this looks compared to the rest of the map. Is that a shitty excuse? Yes, but unfortunately, that's just the way I feel, so. You know. There's a few areas that people can get in windows over here. This whole area kind of reminds me of Detroit in Advanced Warfare. It doesn't really play like that, but just the way it looks. Unfortunately, I don't think you can get up in these. Again, so much verticality that could be fucking wasted. I don't know why Call of Duty is so scared to like do a little thing out of the status quo. I guess they've made a lot of money though staying in that Call of Duty status quo, but still. You know, do something different. Let people fucking use their jetpacks and get up in these fire escapes. That's pretty much this map. This is another small map. This is probably about the size, maybe a little bit bigger than Skyjack. But, I don't know. It's okay. Again, it's my least favorite from the DLC. But, you know, again, like I said earlier, it's Call of Duty. You shoot shit, you die, you respawn. You know, it, ultimately the maps really don't matter that much. I hate to say it, but that's just the way it is. So, that's the 4 multiplayer maps you get. Before we go to zombies, let's see if they've added a DLC playlist. Again, as of yesterday, Tuesday, when the game came out, they had nothing. So, we'll see if they have a DLC-only playlist. It might do what I think Advanced Warfare or Ghost or Black Ops 2 does, and like only put you in with people that also have the DLCs. Like, it knows and it looks for lobbies with people with the DLCs and lets you vote. But I mean, I was having a hard time in just regular lobbies getting onto the DLC maps. Like, maybe 1 in every 3 would pop up. Like, one lobby every 3 lobbies would have a DLC map. So I'm not sure why they didn't add a DLC-only playlist, at least, you know, for launch week. Is beyond me. I'm not sure why they did that. So let's see. We'll just see if they have. So right here is all the standard, hardcore, nothing, bonus. So yeah, they do have a playlist now, which is a shame. I wish I'd known that before I started making this video, and I wouldn't have bored you with just me exploring the map, and we would have actually played them. But you know what? Let's see what's happened. So. Yeah, I don't know if there's a lot of people in it, though, but there is a playlist now for the DLC, so there you go. So what's going to happen now is I'm going to go look at the zombies map. And again, I'm going to warn you right now, it's not going to be in-depth. It's not going to do anything. I'm probably going to play like 5 rounds, show you guys the first 2 or 3 areas that you unlock with doors, and that's it. Because, honestly, the way you play zombies and half the fun of zombies is when you first get it and you try to figure out the map yourself. So by no means is this like an explanation of the map's secrets and the way you do this and how you turn the power on and how you get this perk, yada, yada, yada. It's just an overview. So I'm going to restart the recording on PlayStation because I've been going long again. And when we get back over at the Switch, we'll play some zombies. All right, guys. So we're going to start the zombies now. This is the new map. You play it as the Origin characters, I'm pretty sure, from Black Ops 2. And somehow it ties into that. I never played Origins, so forgive me. But somehow it ties into that giant robot and all the Origins characters. And this is a pretty cool cartoon intro, so I will be quiet and let you guys watch this.
This wasn't how it was supposed to go. We were supposed to secure the package and be in and out clean. Instead, the whole thing's been one disaster after another.
Eat my blade, beast! Ah, fucking move, maggot addicts! Today, you die! 4, 3,
first I took your legs, now I take your life!
I should never have trusted you, Richtofen. Never.
So yeah, pretty cool. Again, it ties into Origins, so I'm sure some of you out there that played Origins understand some of those references. I have never kept up with the zombies narrative. I don't know anything about it, so I have no idea what they're talking about. There is a lot of story in this map, though. Oh, there's the dead robot out there. Holy shit. That's cool. That's pretty cool. I never noticed that. I've only played this once. I didn't notice that before. But, yeah, like I say, I don't really keep up with the narrative. But if you're into it, there is some sort of underlying narrative to this one, so. But anyway, here it is. You start off on, like, this ski thing. And we're going to go here when we have enough money. But, I mean, you know, other than it being a new map, it's Call of Duty Zombies. Look at the headshot. There's still one knife kills. I don't know why I'm not just doing that. You know, I'm not a huge fan of zombies, but I appreciate it. I got a cool calling card. But, like I say, I appreciate zombies kind of from a distance. I never really got super into them, but I do enjoy them every once in a while. And I do kind of like the kind of lore they set up for it. The game mode and the gameplay, not so much, though, honestly. I'm a little more interested in the story, even though I'm not. But yeah, let's go open this door and we'll show off. I'm gonna show off the first 2 areas that you can unlock. Again, I'm not gonna show anything like where the power is and stuff like that. I don't even know. So by the shotgun here. I have always felt capitalism. Come on, what's happening? What's going on? Oh, I don't have enough money. I thought I had 860. I'm dyslexic. I have 680. Okay. This thing is making... I don't know if you guys can hear it on my mic, but this thing is making my PS4 scream. Sounds like a freaking jet going off. But it looks good. I really am always impressed with the graphics that Call of Duty can squeeze out with the frame rate they do on the hardware that they do. It's very impressive. Good game design. For his evil allies to entrap us. I don't know. Again, I don't know if this is in the 40s or 50s or whatever. It seems like it is by the way people are talking and by the way everything looks. I think it's kind of lame, and you zombie people may hate me, but I think it's kind of lame that this is happening in the 40s and we have guns from the Black Ops 3, you know, future. Like right now I'm using this futuristic looking shotgun. Kind of wish that they wouldn't do that. I mean, I understand why they don't. You know, they're not going to put in guns. Oh, and they already have guns that they can use, but still. Just a little thing that I would like to see. Like, maybe have, you know, the, what was it called? The, trench gun instead of this gun, and, you know, an MP40 or something. And there might be in the box, but there's not on the wall. Oh, there's double tap. Right there. Okay. There's some of those gumballs that are the like part of the underlying Black Ops 3 mechanic. I'm not sure how that works, honestly. So this is as far as I'm going to go. I'm going to go to right here, and we're going to stop here. I'm going to play till round 6 if I can survive. There is a place to get the box back here. I will tell you that, but I don't want to show off too much of the map because, again, I really think that... I don't want to spoil anything for anyone. Black Ops 3 zombies are hard, by the way. Just as a little side note. Compared to... like, Black Ops 2 zombies, which had that easy mode and shit, which is what I would play on. Because, you know, when you're playing zombies, you just want to shoot shit. You don't really want to worry about dying. You know, for the most part. Sometimes you might want to challenge, but... oh, look. Okay, so there's, like, some of that stuff. So I imagine this is something, like, in the Alcatraz map from Black Ops 2. Maybe you feed that or something? Huh. I don't know. Again, I don't want to get into the way the map works. I'm just showing it off so that you guys can decide whether or not you want to buy it or not. Yeah, I got 1,300 things. I see a gun on the wall up there. Let's see if we can get it. What is it? A Vesper? Yeah, let's replace this with that. Huh. Looks like there's some kind of rune stuff here. This is interesting. Certainly got my attention. But we'll play to round 6 and we'll call it on this as well. Whoa, what's up? Oh, no, I might die. Whew! I remember when zombie hits by default were 2, so maybe there is a, maybe it is a little bit easier, because I remember that it used to be 2 hits and you were down, and now I guess it's 3. Oh, what is this little gun? This is a little pistol here. I can't buy it. It doesn't look like. Oh yeah, I can. Fuck you. Oh, okay, it's a little machine pistol. Okay. Again, somehow this ties into Origins, but I'm not sure how. That's sick, though. I ain't gonna lie. That's fucking... is that a dragon? I don't know what that is. Some kind of mystical beast popping out of the walls is pretty cool. Alright, well, we made it to round 6, so... that's gonna do it for the look at the zombies. And that's actually gonna do it for this out now. That is Call of Duty Black Ops 3 Awakening. You can get it on PlayStation 4 right now for $15. And it's coming out on Xbox One and PC sometime next month. At least I think PC. PC it could also already be out, but I'm pretty sure that PS4 has a timed exclusive for everything. But yeah, that's the DLC. If you like Call of Duty, you like zombies, it's probably a good investment. I enjoy it for the most part. Anyway, if you like the video, please give it a like, and we'll see you guys next time. Bye.